Are welcome you once again. You are welcome. You are welcome once again. And I want to tell you something. I want to tell you, give you the prophecy of what will happen in Nigeria this year. This prophecy is meant for Nigeria. It's specially made for Nigeria. What will happen in Nigeria? In Nigeria this year, 2019. I'm going to read something for you. I want to read something for you. Then after I finish reading it, I will just tell you something that you should expect to happen in Nigeria. Okay, all right. So I'm reading right now the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 20. 2 Chronicles chapter 20 from verse 1. The prophecy for Nigeria. Prophecy about Nigeria. What you expect. Alright, I'm reading 2 Chronicles 20 from verse 1. It happened after this, that the people of Moab, with the people of Ammon, and the others with them, besides the Ammonites, came to battle against Jehoshaphat. Then some came and told Jehoshaphat, saying, a great multitude is coming against you from beyond the sea, from Syria, and they are in Hazazon Tamar, which is En-Gedi. And Jehoshaphat feared and set himself to seek the Lord and proclaim a feast throughout all Judah. So Judah gathered together to ask help from the Lord, and from all the cities of Judah they came to seek the Lord. Then Jehoshaphat stood in the assembly of Judah and Jerusalem, in the house of the Lord before the new court, and said, O Lord God of our fathers, are you not God in heaven, and do you not rule over all the kingdoms of the nations? And in your hand is there no power and might, so that no one is able to withstand you? Are you not our God, who drove out the inhabitants of this land before your people Israel and gave it to the descendant of Abraham, your friend forever? And they dwell in it, and have built you a sanctuary in it for your name, saying, if disaster comes upon us, war, judgment, pestilence, or famine, we will stand before this temple in your presence, for your name is in this temple, and cry out to you in our affliction, and you will hear and save. And now here are the people of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir, whom you would not let Israel invade when they came out of the land of Egypt, but they turned from them and did not destroy them. Here they are rewarding us by coming to throw us out of your possession, which you have given us to inherit. O our God, will you not judge them? For we have no power against this great multitude that is coming against us, nor do we know what to do, but our eyes are upon you. Now all Judah with their little ones, their wives, and their children stood before the Lord. Then the Spirit of the Lord came upon Jahaziel, the son of Zechariah, the son of Benaiah, the son of Jeiel, the son of Mataniah, a Levite of the sons of Asaph, in the midst of the assembly, and he said, listen, all you of Judah, and you inhabitant of Jerusalem, and you, King Jehoshaphat, thus says the Lord to you, do not be afraid nor dismayed because of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God. Tomorrow go down against them, they will surely come up by the ascent of Aziz, and you will find them at the end of the brook before the wilderness of Jeruel. You will not need to fight in this battle. Position yourself, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, who is with you, O Judah and Jerusalem. Do not fear or be dismayed. Tomorrow go out against them, for the Lord is with you. And Jehoshaphat bowed his head with his face to the ground. And all Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem bowed before the Lord, worshipping the Lord. Then the Levites and the children of the Kohathites and of the children of the Korahites stood up to praise the Lord God of Israel with voices loud and high. So when they rose early in the morning and went out into the wilderness of Tekoa, and as they went out, Jehoshaphat stood and said, "Hear me! Hear me, O Judah, and you inhabitants of Jerusalem. Believe in the Lord your God, and you shall be established. Believe his prophets, and you shall prosper." And when he had consulted with the people, he appointed those who should sing to the Lord, and who should praise the beauty of holiness, as they went out before the army, and they were saying, "Praise the Lord, for his mercy endures forever." Now, when they began to sing and to praise, the Lord set ambushes against the people of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir, who had come against Judah, and they were defeated. For the people of Ammon and the Moab stood up against the inhabitants of Mount Seir to utterly kill and destroy them. And when they had made an end of the inhabitants of Seir, they helped to destroy one another. So when Judah came to a place overlooking the wilderness, they looked towards the multitude, and there were their dead bodies. And there were their dead bodies falling on the earth. No one had escaped. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is prophecy of Nigeria that I'm giving to you now. The evil in Nigeria, evil will belly evil. In Nigeria, this is all that I just read now that you hear, like what I just read now. The evil in Nigeria, evil will belly evil in Nigeria this year. Evil will face evil. If you are a child of God, what God expects from you is just to praise and worship God. You need to praise him. Don't need to fight in this world. All we need to do is to praise. God said that all that he needs from us is praise. As you hear this prophecy, all you need to offer God is praise. God said that this one is not your battle. The battle is not yours, but our God is the one that will fight the battle for his children. Evil will destroy, evil will self-destruct, self-destruction, self. People will use their hand and they kill themselves. People will use their hands and destroy themselves. Enemy will face enemy and destroy themselves. APC will face PDP and destroy themselves. PDP will face APC. Fake pastor facing fake pastor. Fake member facing fake member. Native doctors facing native doctors. All the wicked people that say that Nigeria will not be good, we face each other. Utter destroyers, self-destruct. They will use their hands and destroy themselves. This is what God said to me about Nigeria. That evil in them, the selfishness in them, in those fake pastors, in those wicked politicians, in those their followers that is jumping up and down and writing comments and fighting for their fake pastors. He said, God said, they will destroy themselves. But what God made from his two children is just praise. And worship God. Can you come on, give God praise? Come on, give him praise. All you need now is just go ahead. Come on, wonderful praise. God revealed something to me that marvels me. God took me before the end of the year. On the 30th night, the Lord showed me a wonderful vision in Nigeria. So in this revelation, a church in Nigeria, where God took me, I saw all the pastors in Nigeria. So they all gather together with politicians. They are together. They are eating together. They are doing everything in common. There is nothing. They are friends. When they do evil, they laugh. They are happy. When they kill the innocent people, they are laughing. When they are starving the people, when they are tormenting the people, they are happy. They are celebrating. They are happy. God took me in the spirit. And in that church, I saw a Bible that they're using. Satanic Bible. If you open the first page, like Genesis, you will see the picture of Adeboye and all that he's saying. Not what God said, but what he is saying. His own evil devices and his own evil methods is what was written down in the whole Genesis. You open another one, you see the picture, a very big picture of a variable. With all that he's saying is what will be seen, not the word of God, but what he is saying, his own evil plot and plans and the war that's suit him and will make people to, that will lure people into that, into his evil, the trap is all that, that is written there. You open another one, you see Kumuyi picture, full picture, you know, standing, and all that saying. This is how from Genesis to Revelation, all that I'm seeing is Nigerian pastors, pictures, and all that are saying, and they write it demonic Bible at the back, demonic Bible. So God said to me that these people have turned themselves to become God, that everything they are saying is not what he said, but instead, what they formulated from their from the demonic world, that what they bring out, the demonic water they bring out, and they give to their members, and the members are drinking it, and the members are believing it, and this is how it is done in occultic world. All that they are saying is demonic world, like in Illuminati. You saw all these singers, all this American hip-hop, they are vomiting poison in their mouth, and the followers are flowing it, and they are buying it. And this, you know, another thing that I want you to understand is that they are also monitoring any true child of God, any true anointed child of God, to see that they get him frustrated and destroyed. But God said, now they will destroy themselves. They will destroy themselves. Because these are Illuminati we are seeing, occultism we are seeing. How can a demonic Bible be found in Nigeria? Nothing like Jesus, nothing like God in what they are doing. All that I'm seeing is every chapter you open, you see a Deboye picture standing and all that is saying. You open another one, you see a Yodepo. You open another one, you see a Kumuyi. You open another one, you see Cass Embassy, Ekilome. You open another one, you see Bakadi. You open another one, you see all of them pictures and all that they are saying, all that they are using to deceive their gullible members. But I'm giving you prophecy of what God said. God said that self-destruct, that selfishness in them, that evil in them will destroy them. They will destroy themselves. As you hear here in this place, in this is called Chronicles chapter 20, that all the enemy that gathered against Jehoshaphat and the children of Israel, they end up, as they are praising God, they destroy themselves, self-destruct. Selfishness in them destroyed them. The self in them destroyed them. The self in the life of Nigerian pastors and politicians are great. And this is what will destroy them. Self-destruct. Self-destruct. This is what God said to me, that we destroy all of them, that they will join hands and destroy each other. I said to you, fake pastor versus fake pastor, fake members versus fake member, evil politician versus evil politician. So they will have themselves PDP destroying, fighting PDP against APC, APC against PDP. They all of them will join hands together and finish themselves up. As we go on and praise God, I say to you that evil in Nigeria, evil will bury evil, evil will destroy evil this year. This is my prophecy as I hear from God, that God, what God said that will happen in that country called Nigeria. All right, so you have heard this. I want you to go ahead. Go ahead and praise. Come on, go ahead. Let us give God praise. Go ahead and give. God did not demand you to fight in this one, because you can't even fight, because the enemy, the evil is great. You can't even fight. But our God alone is able to destroy, to see that the evil that you are seeing end. The evil, it's not even God fighting, but the evil in them is too much. I've reached heaven. That evil is what we kill them and destroy them. Self is the enemy. When somebody is over self-centered, that person becomes devil. So now I want you to go ahead and give God praise. Spread this message. Let everybody hear what God said about Nigeria. The only thing we need to do is go ahead, give God a crazy praise as he go on to do the work for me. And you, Nigeria, will never be the same again. God bless you really good. As you hear this, spread the news, spread everywhere, and let us stand in praise. Join hand and praise our God. He is awesome. He's a great God. He did this in the days of old. He's still God. He will do it now again, and you keep on doing it. Power belongs to our God. Hallelujah. God bless you.